I think that the work itself, the art form, you know, holds many hundreds of stories and experiences and moments in time of interaction with people. They're like diaries. They're like novels. They tell a story of life and experience. Probably carried these beads around for 20 years before they ever found an expression in terms of a formalized piece of beadwork. And that double curve, which you see expressed here, is very typical of ancient woodlands design. So. And these actually are chestnut leaves. It references the ancient indigenous trees that once populated Lenapehoking.
When I'm holding a seed, part of what I'm thinking about is what hands held these seeds before mine?
Yeah.
And what hands held the seeds before that, and before that, and before that? Because that's the only reason this seed is here, is because of that lineage of hands. The seeds are a celebration of place, especially because they're returning to this land that they were separated from.
Growing up in Oklahoma, as a child, I'd never seen a bandolier bag except in photographs. In other words, they were no longer in anyone's holdings, any family connection within our tribal community. They had all been collected and removed. I mean, many of these historic bags are from that 1850s period, a period of relocation by the U.S. government, of expulsion from home communities into unknown foreign and far distant lands. And yet, these art forms were created. And for me, they were created, you know, as a reminder. They're very much about survivance and continuation, you know. So these are not just decorative objects. They hold a life story.
Yeah. Seeds were turned into commodities and treated like objects, even though they're alive.
Yeah.
And there's so much more than just, you know, the yield, what they're going to produce.
Right.
Every seed is a living being.
Yeah.
And there's a relationship.
A relationship.
Between people and the seeds. And the meaning of that relationship is very much about culture.
Yeah.
And understanding of the natural world. Mm-hmm. And there's an art to growing.
Yes.
And there's an art to saving seeds. But when we look at indigenous communities, there was a forceful and deliberate separation. You take any cultural art forms and you destroy them, and then you move the people away from their soils, away from their experience of the natural world. And that's what's led to this separation. And in order to find some of these seeds, we had to figure out who were the collectors who held these seeds, even if they weren't Lenape people.
In the way that the bandolier bags were collected and removed from communities and became part of the private sector, the collector, or the museum, and they were held in storage on the shelves for generations.
The return is powerful and significant because it's also a recognition of the trauma. It's a recognition of what happened.
400 years until today, it's taken that much time to really celebrate and give voice to the original people of this ancestral land. No museum has stepped forward to really offer as a venue their exhibition space to recognize the original people of New York. I also love the idea of including this plant material, in the actual exhibition space, because we have these amazing bean tapestries, this bean lace, if you want to call it or refer to it that way, that will spill over the transparent walls of the gallery. We'll also be able to, later as the season progresses, add plants to the exhibit on the rooftop garden. The Chickasaw plum, the beach plum, again, that's a revival or a renaissance, a return of the foodways of the ancestral people. So we want to wrap our arms around all those topics and all those conversations through this exhibit.
And to bring people in, like you're saying, in a sort of a democratic environment where it's all different kinds of people, because that's how libraries work, and we're inviting them into this conversation through beauty, through sustenance, through life.